And then I said on the phone, I told him, I said, listen, stop. You want to kill him? You know what he said?
What?
I don't care. If he dies, I'll get me a new one.
And he said that about
He said that, yeah.
السلام عليكم ورحمة الله. معاكم هاني من جيم ايجيبت. النهاردة عاملين حلقة وتغطية خطيرة جدا من نوع خاص. معنا دينيس جيمس النهاردة هيتكلم للعرب، هيقول وجهة نظره، هيتكلم عن الإشاعات اللي طلعت عليه.
Hello Dennis.
How are you?
I'm fine. How's everything?
Everything is good. Everything is good. I can't complain.
Nice. So right now, always, when Dennis James name get up, there is always some talks. People start to talk. So what do you think about that? Is it you are like making troubles or the troubles following you?
I don't even know. I don't know what you mean trouble, because I don't even know what most of people talk about. You know, I have not, because I don't understand. I don't understand Arabic, so I don't understand what the real situation is. And I don't know why there's a problem, because I don't have any problems. You know what I mean? So I don't see the problems.
The problem, I'm gonna show you our side. In the beginnings, we see you taking Rami and you take him in very good direction and you were training him and everything was like nice and easy and it was going to the right direction and everything was fine.
Mm.
So suddenly you split with him. We didn't know why, we didn't know what happened, and the people start to talk and we listen for the people that always come from Kuwait, that Dennis did that, Dennis do this, did it. Dennis, he's the bad guy, he's the evil one, he's. So we need to know the truth right now. Are you the bad guy or the good guy?
If I was an evil guy, then I think there would be other people somewhere around in the world that would have something evil to say about me. How come it's always only the people in Kuwait? I'm not even want to talk about the people from Kuwait, because the people in Kuwait are nice people. There's a certain group of people that only have something to say about me. So if I was an evil person, there must be, should be more. So all the problems that, not problems, because I don't consider it a problem. To me, it's not a problem when some people hate on my success, because I don't hate on other people's success. When other people have success, I'm happy for them. And this is the way it should be. I should be happy if you have success.
Yeah.
I shouldn't hate on you if you have success, especially if you make the success by yourself. Protecting Rami and Egyptian people, because they told me in Kuwait, and this, I never asked for that. I never mentioned that until in one interview, that all people from Kuwait here are just taxi drivers. They just...
People in Kuwait are taxi drivers?
That's what they say. And drivers for people with
Egyptians,
money.
Egyptians, you mean?
The Egyptians, I'm sorry.
Okay,
yeah. That's what this group of people. They were speaking bad about Egyptian people from the first day I come to Kuwait. They basically taught me. They taught me that Egyptians are only liars. In the Arab world, everybody knows Egyptian people are liars. That's what they tell me. I said, how is that possible? You know, and I know for, and this is what they told me. I mean, this particular person told me that in my face, and had a driver was Egyptian, and that driver took care of me every day, drove me. I like this person. I never been to Egypt in my life. I want to go to Egypt very, very bad. Why would I speak bad about Egyptian? I only, in protecting Egyptians, I said, why these people jump and believe people that speak bad about Egyptians? Because they told me that taxi drivers or drivers, liars. You know what I mean?
Hmm.
And I get a lot of emails, not emails, messages on Facebook where Egyptian people say, oh, you speak bad about Rami, you call him a fisherman.
Yeah, I was going to ask you about that.
Yeah.
That after you split with Rami in training and the advertising,
I never,
you called him that because he left you, so you start to be like insulting him and say that he's a fisherman. And
I never insult. No, I never insulted him. I said the same thing I've been saying since I know him. He said, "Look at him going from a fisherman to one of the best bodybuilders in the world."
Yeah.
Where's the insult?
No, no, no.
He was a fisherman. Am I correct?
It was fact. Yeah. And Rami was like.
So why would I insult him if I say he used to be a fisherman?
Yeah. And
that's Rami, not an insult.
Rami, even I want to profit too for the people who's watching. Rami was in Egypt like a week ago, and he already, when he visit his city, he take a picture next big boat, and because he's a fisherman. This is the truth.
And what's wrong with being a fisherman?
No,
I only said.
They make it like you are insulting him.
Yeah,
you
know? I'm not insulting anybody. I'm just basically speaking up for Rami when I say about. Why is he not doing that? People ask me, can he win the Olympia? I said, absolutely yes. I said, why do you think he is not coming into condition, you know, that he needs to be? Every year the condition is not 100, he's big. I said, listen, understand, he used to be a fisherman. And in 3-4 years, he's one of the best bodybuilders in the world. Give this man a chance to adjust to a different lifestyle. Yeah. Everything is going very fast for him. And that's why I said, he's going from a fisherman for making a little bit of money to all of a sudden being the most talked about bodybuilder on the planet for making more money. This doesn't go in easy. You can't just, you know, adjust from this to that. You have to slow. It's slow. You have to be slow. And everybody tried to push him to do everything very fast. Yeah, you got to be Mr. Olympia. Yeah. He will be Mr. Olympia, but he's got to take his time. He's young.
Even he's not working with you, you're still saying that he can be Mr.
Olympia. I still believe that he is...
the future.
The future of the sport. If he nails it, he will be unbeatable until he
returns. You think he can push Phil Heath?
I think he can. Imagine if he would be in 100% condition.
Yeah, for sure.
I don't think anybody can even be close.
Yeah.
It would be a no contest.
Did you see one on the stage like Rami before?
No, and I said it how many years now?
Yeah.
I said he is 1 out of 1 billion people.
Yeah.
To have another Rami, it's probably going to take another 30 years before we have somebody like him come again.
All my questions about Rami right now, it's not about, we are not talking about Rami as a sportman, but we are like, I'm trying to prove for the people right now that Dennis, even when he split with Rami, he still love him. He's still wishing for him. Like
I told Rami in the very beginning, because Rami, you know, Rami is, how can I explain? Rami is a person, he doesn't like to hurt people.
Yes, so much.
Okay?
Very kind.
And I know, because when we work together, and Rami knows, I've never done anything like this for another man.
Yeah.
And we took care of him like a baby. And he's not a baby. We call him the big baby in my house.
Yeah.
We took care of him because I know it's a lot. It's a lot to do for somebody that's not used to it. He's used to sitting in the gym 6-10 hours a day. And basically just talking to people. All of a sudden, you got to do photo shoots. You got to do this. You got to train. You got to look good. People expect you to win. This is a lot of pressure.
Yeah.
I try to take this pressure away from him because I've been doing this for 23 years.
Yeah.
So I help him to take this pressure away from him so he can focus only on what he has to do on a daily basis. So he doesn't want to hurt people. So when he's not happy with his condition, you know, you have the right to change. Or you go to a different a trainer.
Yeah.
We don't have a contract. And I told him, I said, Rami, because I hear from other people that he wasn't happy with his condition. He never said he's not happy with me, because I don't think you will find another man that will do as much as I did for one person. And I'm not saying that I did this because, you know, I had to do it. I did because I felt he needs to learn the right way. And I believe right now Rami is at this point where I think he's very happy that I was there in times when nobody knew what to do.
Can you take somebody else and put him in the same spot like Rami?
Yes, but I don't know if I find somebody with the same body.
Yeah.
But can I hype and can promote? Yeah, this is what I do. I can do it.
Yeah.
And this is what I did for Rami. And this is what they wanted me to do for Rami too.
Actually, yeah.
That's what they wanted me to do.
So, because the stuff that it was happening and saying too that you like come as a promoter and suddenly you spot yourself as a trainer. So, and it wasn't like that. They were training Rami for a long time and you just come steal it from them. Is it true or no?
That's not true. I didn't steal anybody. You know what I mean? Let me tell you something. These guys act like gurus. I mean, I don't even talk about these guys because all the chihuahuas around him, they don't even know anything.
Okay.
And he didn't know nothing either because I've been helping this guy with his athletes for many, many, many years. When they in shows, they call me and ask me how many diuretics, how much this, how much that. I do this in the background. I never told anybody.
Yeah.
So I'm pretty sure he never told anybody either. He probably told everybody this is me.
Uh-huh.
He wants to be the guru. How are you going to be a guru? You have shisha places and gyms. You're not a guru. Just do what you do best. Don't do what you don't know.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? And if you learn, if you learn from some, everybody can learn. And if you learn from somebody, at least acknowledge that somebody taught you.
Yeah, for sure.
I can't say, I'm not going to sit here and say everything I know is because I taught myself. I've learned from others.
Yeah, for sure.
I worked with trainers. I worked with Charles Glass. I've learned from these people. I would never sit here and talk bad about these people. They taught me. They basically helped me where I am today. I mean, you got to be where you're at because you take care of business. But I would never burn these people because they helped me. You want to tell me that he learned it from what? From you know, it doesn't fall from the sky, the information.
So how suddenly Kuwait jumped to be number one in bodybuilding.
Mm-hmm.
How did this happen?
Think about it. All the knowledge we brought to Kuwait. The knowledge.
Yes.
Since I went there, you know how many pros I brought to Kuwait? And every pro has a different knowledge.
Yeah.
So you take all the knowledge. They'll learn. That's why he brought these guys over. We came over to teach. We basically taught these people.
So you regret it?
If we would have
teach the people?
No, I don't regret anything because the people were nice. And now I can see that what we taught them helps.
Yeah.
Look at him today.
Yeah.
This doesn't come because he all of a sudden reading the internet how to get big.
Yeah.
This come from bringing us over.
Yeah.
He's learned from us. So acknowledge. Just acknowledge.
Did he pay for that?
Of course, yes. He paid. Everybody we brought over, he paid. Of course, these guys, this is their business.
Yeah.
But it's not the kind of money that these people think. When he brought me over, I stayed for 1 month for $5,000. What was that?
Yeah.
So people, the way he puts me in the limelight, he should have paid me $100,000 a month.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I mean?
Oh, okay, yeah.
But he wasn't even close.
Yeah.
So, and I did a lot of things when he said he brought me. I wanted to come to Kuwait to train Rami, and that wasn't true either. He said that on an interview. It's not true because he wanted me to bring Flex Magazine over there to promote his gym. He is all about promotion of his gym. He doesn't care about the members too much.
Do you think this is like good thing?
Well, maybe he cares for the members because he brings the pros over. This is for the members.
Yeah, yeah.
But it's for him, it's all about promoting Oxygen. It's not about anything else.
Is it good or bad?
It's his business.
Yeah,
I would never say anything about him being a bad businessman.
Yeah.
This is your business.
Yeah.
You're successful. More power to you.
Yeah.
I wouldn't talk bad about you. I'm not going to sit here and say...
You never say that Oxygen is bad gym.
No. I still say Oxygen gym is fucking awesome. There's nothing you can say about it.
Yeah.
I'm a man. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
I don't pull nuts out of my ass and come up with a bullshit lie to make you believe somebody is bad when he's not.
So the question will gonna be for you right now. If he find him, you think he have the right to always say that I made Rami, or it was like he start and Rami start continue the gym.
I don't think anybody has the right to say I made Rami.
Yeah.
Because if Rami wouldn't train, if Rami wouldn't diet,
yeah, it won't happen.
It won't happen.
Yeah, yeah.
So why is somebody that wants to be a coach or a guru or why I want to take the credit for guys?
Yeah.
They put the work in. I only give my suggestion. So does that make me the man, or does it make him the man?
Yeah.
He is the man. Why would I take this away from him? Why would I let people think he ain't nothing? It's all me.
Yeah.
Because he told me the whole time he told me that he pays everything for Rami. He pays for his apartment. He paid for everything. And, you know, Rami told me that's not true. And everything I say.
Well, Rami cleared that area on our national TV in Egypt last time when he was in Egypt. And he said that I sell my own furniture in the home and they sell my wife's home to keep going in that sport.
Exactly. And he told me, Rami also told me that he borrowed. Yes, I borrowed from him $5,000.
Okay.
But he paid him back. So how can you say that you paid for everything? How? When you give him, supposedly you're supposed to give him $600 a month for being in your gym promoting all day, then pay him. Don't just say it. But it doesn't matter. What matters is, don't take credit for something that somebody else did. Take the credit for, say, I found him. I basically saw his talent. Take the credit for that.
So
he didn't make him. Yeah. He didn't make
Dennis,
him.
Do you say that you have credit that you make Rami something?
No.
Never.
For what? Why would I want credit for something that I helped because I wanted to help a friend? And in the beginning, I'll help a friend, which I mean is him.
Yeah.
I wanted to help him. I helped him to promote his gym. He put this video out, like I'm saying, you know, yeah, you know, bada this and bada. Yeah, I said that because I wanted to help him. You know, he wants to be the Joe Weed of I don't know what.
Middle East, yeah.
Yeah. So, and be friends. So I help you as much as I can, correct?
Yeah, for sure.
So why wouldn't I say what I said? Ask me if I would say it again today.
You say it today?
No, I would not say it again because he blackballed me. He basically, how can I say? He uses you until he don't need you. When he doesn't need you no more, he's going to get rid of you.
This, you know, way.
This is his way. I remember one time, because Rami told me later that whatever I told him to do, he would quadruple that. Why would you do that? Why would you force somebody to stick something in him, come into the office, do it in front of him so he has proof? He was bleeding out the nose. Why would you do that? Why? And then I said on the phone, I told him, I said, listen, stop. You want to kill him? You know what he said?
What?
I don't care. If he dies, I'll give me a new one.
He said that about
he
Rami?
Said that, yes. And if he thinks, and you can come back and come up with another lie, I guarantee you whatever I tell you is the truth. Okay, it's the truth. Fuck him if he died. The donkey. Everybody's a donkey.
He said that.
I listened to him speak about other people for 10 years. You know what I mean? So now I listen from other people what he says about me, and it's always the same. It's the same words. Nothing's changed. You know what I'm saying? So if he would be, you know, he's a good businessman, but if he would be smart, he would just shut his mouth and just do his business.
Yeah.
Because he doesn't live off the American people, or he lives off the Kuwaiti people.
Yeah.
Do your business in Kuwait. Be a good person over there. Do your thing. You know, don't care about others. He told Rami he made my career. I had a career before I knew who he was.
Yeah.
This is what I want to say.
Yeah.
This is now, wait, let's wait with the Middle East. Let's go to the Egyptians first. I was portrayed as somebody that speaks bad about Egyptians. This is to all Egyptian people, and I hope when you translate this, you translate it to the point.
Yeah.
The only thing I said about Egyptian people, because I've never been to Egypt, I don't know a lot of Egyptians, so this I cannot say something about any Egyptian people because I don't have the experience. I can only tell you what they taught me. Not that I believe it, but I said it so they would know how they speak about Egyptian people.
Yeah.
I was taught that Egyptians are liars. Egyptians are come to Kuwait for being the taxi drivers or whatever. I never said this for myself. I only said, why would they act like, you know, Egyptians are bad when they use Egyptians to make a name for themselves? Rami is Egyptian. How are you going to speak bad about Rami when he's going to help you right now promote all your gyms?
Yeah.
You know what I mean? Let Rami go away from Kuwait. Why do you think he was so mad when he left? Because this was going to cost him his business.
Yeah, for sure.
His business would go down.
Mm.
That's the only reason. You think he cares for Rami? Do you really believe that? From what I heard coming from his mouth,
yeah.
I'll tell you right now, I highly doubt it.
Okay.
Let somebody else come that looks just the same and see what happens. But it doesn't matter. So for me personally, I know four or five Egyptian people. I know one Egyptian lady, and I would never say anything negative about a country that I've never been to.
Yeah.
So whoever heard that I speak bad about Egyptians, it's a lie. I can promise you all, I put this on my wife and on my daughter. It's a lie. I never said anything negative about Egyptians. Did I call these people camel crew? Yes. Why? I don't even know. I thought it was a joke.
Uh-huh.